President Marcos directs the Metro Manila Development Authority to temporarily halt the apprehension of e-vehicles on national roads in the capital region. He called for a grace period but did not specify the duration. On Monday, a ban targeting those types of vehicles took effect in a bid to lessen accidents involving them. The MMDI has already begun apprehending such vehicles, imposing a fine of 2,500 on violators and impounding vehicles lacking proper licenses or registration documents. An ambitious effort aiming to provide electricity to 300 million people in Africa in the next 6 years now underway. Leading the charge, the World Bank and African Development Bank Group. The World Bank will work to connect 250 million electricity through distributed renewable energy systems or the distribution grid, while the African Development Bank will look to provide energy to the other 50 million. The World Bank estimates $30 billion of public sector investment will be needed for the project. Currently, some 600 million Africans lack access to electricity. State Weather Bureau Pagasa warns temperatures, especially in Luzon, will likely continue rising, especially during the month of May. According to Pagasa's Climate Monitoring and Prediction Section Chief Ana Solis, there's a possibility that parts of the Philippines will experience a heat index of 52 degrees Celsius and above in the coming weeks. She urges caution as these dangerous conditions put the public at risk of heat strokes.
Historically kasi, medyo ang matataas nating temperatura na iitala during the months of April as well as during the months of May. Kaya dito nakikita natin na possible pa rin na patuloy na iinit at tataas ang ating temperatura. Pagdating ng Mayo, asahan po natin lalo na dyan sa may parte ng Cagayan Valley area, dyan po sa may parte ng Isabela, ng Cagayan, pati na po dyan sa may Ilocos region, medyo may init din po. Kasama na po dyan yung sa Central Luzon area and also itong mga karating na mga probinsya ng Metro Manila, dyan po sa Batangas, Cavite, na medyo coastal areas.
Corporate stories this Thursday, Manila Water is taking a majority stake, in fact, in the firm which manages Laguna's water district. Its unit is buying 70% of shares in Equi Pacific Holdco, Incorporated, for 1.15 billion pesos. EHI has a 90% stake in the joint venture, which operates and maintains the water supply in 5 towns in Laguna. The acquisition will allow Manila Water to strategically grow operations in the province. Next, Balaini Frutas, further diversifying its product offerings. Lesser use firm signed a deal today to acquire the 40-year-old Sugar House Bake Shop for a still undisclosed amount. Balai is also taking over the catering business of Sugar House, with the acquisition set to be completed by May. In other company news, Basic Energy and Japan's Renova teaming up for a wind project in Batangas. The two firms entered into a joint development and shareholders agreement to develop the 50-megawatt wind power facility in Mabini Town. The wind project begins operations by 2027 with an estimated cost of 4.5 billion pesos. Finally, in earnings, Rockwell Land surpasses its pre-pandemic profit. Its net income after tax was at 3.4 billion pesos last year, higher by 31% year on year. The Lopez family's property developer also posted higher revenues of 18.5 billion pesos from its residential and commercial businesses. It notes retail revenues were up 27% on improved occupancy and rental rates on top of new retail store openings.